Okay, this is a video summary. First of all, don't attempt this type of work if you're not mechanically minded. Okay. The first thing I'd like to point out is the opposite side to the motor. So there's the motor on this left-hand side roller door here. The opposite side is under tension. Okay, and if you undo the U-bolt. If you undo this bolt here, the U-bolt on top of the bracket, you'll lose spring tension and the roller door will fall to the ground, which can be, of course, very dangerous. Don't undo the U-bolt to the opposite side of the motor. If that does happen, you're going to have to try to pull down on the top to wind it up, which is dangerous. At that point, you may be better off getting a professional. And what you do is you get a plumber's clamp and you have to build up spring tension. So you pull it down, you wind the metal rod, and then you do up the bolts with a screw gun in your right hand if you're right-handed. You reposition the clamp and you pull it down and rotate it you undo them and turn it and then do it up. Okay, reposition, undo them, turn it until you build up spring tension again. So again, make sure that the U-bolt here is secure and done up before you replace the motor. And on this side, where the motor is, you would make sure that that U-bolt is done up and secure. Another important thing is once all the work's done and your motor's installed correctly, just remember that these motors can turn, of course, clockwise and anti-clockwise because it can be installed on the right side or the left side, as in this one here. Okay, and here we see that it can be selected for right hand or left hand installation, okay, and that's with the programming guide here. Some reason I can't really. Okay, I've swapped over to the non-fisheye lens, and that seems to be better. So you can pause it at any time just to read through these. This is what's in my manual, and I'm filming this for safety. So this is the programming. Okay. This is to program the automatic opener. Here's a bit more information. Again, you can pause this or fast forward it if you'd rather not see this information. However, this could save somebody from a very bad situation. Just have to remember that the motor can go clockwise or anti-clockwise, and that U-bolt is holding all of the spring tension. There's a spring running right through the roller door, through the middle of it, okay? And that's what you would be tightening up if you did lose spring tension. You had to build it up. You're actually winding up a huge spring. Inside the roller door drum, okay? So, safety first. Okay. There's a section here on troubleshooting too. Okay, there's troubleshooting. Okay. Diagnostics. This might apply to the roller door you're working on. Okay. Okay, so as I say, there is a very large spring going through the middle of it, and if you undo the U-bolt, that will unwind and this will drop to the floor quite rapidly. Now, to put on the motor, you have to undo the bracket. So the motor is on this shaft from the drum of the roller door. Now, we see here, there's a bracket, okay, and that fits to the wall. You have to remove this bracket and then get the old one off, put the new one on, and then refit the bracket. Now, you ask yourself, well, okay, but what is the a roller door going to sit on? Well, of course, it's going to be wound up. So you get a ladder. I used that ladder there. You'll see this is all in the video, that ladder there, and I face it that way. I'll put blocks and pack it out, and you put a ratchet strap around the drum, around the roller door, and I also supported mine up over the framework here. And I found that I could actually make some adjustments. I don't want to confuse anybody. All of the work has been filmed and is after this introduction section. All of this, what I talk about, is on video, okay? Also, if you're taking notes and you have to do this work, remember to mark the original how it's situated on the bracket, okay? So when you put it back, you can bring this to the right position out from the wall. Okay, so you need to, if that's there now, you need to know where it was if you remove the bracket. This is a tie-in. This is a tie-in post. So this ties, this is all different types of framework, and then you've got a beam coming across here that this roof truss sits on, and all this, and there was some flexing. Yes, this was removed, but there was a little bit of flexing before that, and this section from the floor to here had moved out, and then this sort of buckled back. So this tie-in post here, this ties everything together and makes the wall straight, and then, of course, this is the original bit coming off the framework, okay? But in a normal situation, maybe they're building, they've worked out a better method for building this front wall, because there's a lot of weight on this section, okay, and this is separate, okay, so you probably won't have to, but if you do have movement, well, here's an idea, okay. It's just a post, it's cut straight on top. We've got coach bolts, two coach bolts here, because this part of the wall actually moved in this amount, okay. So because this is tightened up, the post is, there was a gap here, but now because the post is on the wall, there's only about, and I packed it out with this bit here to pack out to the same level as the wall. So we can, just to simplify it, we can take 7 mil off that, and we can say that from above my thumb, that's how much the post has brought the wall in. So we've got two coach bolts there, because that was under tension. We've got one at the top, one here, and one there. Okay, I think that's it. I hope that I've helped you out. As I say, this is only the introduction, and the video follows this part of the video. So all the best. Take real care. Think things through. I know a lot of people are under a lot of pressure to do their own work for financial reasons. Just really be careful, okay? Okay, here's the video after this point. One last thing, don't forget to put your manual up on the wall for next time you need it or the next owner needs it. And also, the warning has to be fixed where people can see it, okay, because children, if they're playing underneath, they can be struck, and if you can think of it, it's already happened, so be careful. Okay, roller door installation. It's the 14th of the 5th, 2023. Unfortunately, this roller door motor has given up the ghost. I've looked into it, and I've decided that it's best to replace. Got the same on the other side. It would have been good to get the same model. However, it looks like it's no longer made. This is what it's supposed to do. And with a remote, okay. And now with this one, we'll plug it in. And there's nothing there. So as I said, I looked into it a bit, and it's found to be faulty for whatever reason. This has lasted a good amount of time. This was installed around about 2008, toward the end of 2008, start of 2009, and it's now 23, right? So that's a good amount of time. It's more than 10 years. Okay, so with these, we can get the stopper out of the lock there. And or is it in it? It's supposed to be in the ball in the cup, and it'll lift. Requires a fair amount of force. Okay, so I've watched some videos, and they say to make sure that this end is tightened and secure, because you don't want this dropping on you. It's very heavy. Okay, so what we'll do is support the roller door with a ladder. Then we'll remove the obstacles. Obstacles being this piece of pine framing. This would have been removed by the looks of things the last time I installed the motor. And then the bracket, we'll remove the bracket. Okay, and looks like there should be enough room. I'm not sure. Maybe the other one has to come out as well.
to get the motor off, because realistically there's only the gap between there and there. So it may have to be tweaked a bit and just brought forward. Take this off, put the new motor on, put it all back together and install the remote. I'd say that the remote would have to be, you know, made compatible with the motor. So that's what we're looking at the moment. That's one of today's jobs. Okay, unfortunately at this point, spring tension is lost. The U-bolt on the opposite side of the motor was done up, and I checked that it was done up, but still the rod turned and I did lose spring tension. So I lost spring tension, and to try to move forward, I've removed the ladder, and the door has fallen to the ground, but the drum is still supported on the brackets. So what happened was I lost spring tension, and the roller door and the drum have buckled on the supporting ladder. To prevent this, you could get a small gauge ratchet strap and put it around the roller door to keep everything in place if you did lose spring tension. So at this point, having lost spring tension, we're now going to start to build spring tension, fix the situation and move forward. So we start by pulling down on the front of the drum, and then as the roller door winds onto the drum, we pull down on the front of the roller door to pull the door back onto the drum. To build spring tension, you will need a big plumber's clamp. You'll have to back off the bolts and wind the shaft inside the drum and keep on with that technique. I'll just say at this point also that professional roller door installers would have a different technique to mine. I'm doing this job for the first time, or second time, because I did install these roller motors. Although I didn't have problems with losing spring tension when I installed the motors back in, I think, 2008. Please note that when installing the new roller door motor, I have a ratchet strap around the drum and the roller door. Also, the roller door supported over a beam on top of the roller door on the ceiling. So please support the roller door first, just in case you lose spring tension. I found that the ribbing design of the roller door itself gives the impression that the roller door won't move after spring tension is lost. And of course, once you remove the support, the ladder underneath, or whatever it is you're using, the roller door will fall to the ground. Not the drum, not the entire thing. It'll stay on the bracket, but it'll just unwind. I'm starting to think that maybe the best way to put a new roller door motor on is to actually back off spring tension, install it, and then build spring tension once the new motor's installed. However, that takes more time. It makes the whole thing more complex, and you need special tools, you know, a plumber's clamp to build spring tension. I suppose that's why it's not done that way. Another thing at this point, it's actually the 22nd of the 3rd, 2024 now, so it's been a while since I've been able to work on this video. This video does show all complications that can happen during a roller door installation or a motor installation. Okay, before we get on with the video, I'm just going to show the outside wall straightness, and this will make more sense as we get further into the video. So So that's how the wall was when finished. Just quickly, it's about installing this post to make this wall and this area here and the wall straighter. Okay, let's watch more of the video. Okay, now what can happen here is you can lose spring tension, okay? When they tell you to undo this side and undo that side, it can unravel. Now, I think I've got the job turned around now. So I've undone these bolts and I've released the clutch so that you can turn. It's still got a lot of tension on it. Now, this is supposed to be loose and you use these plumbing clamps to tighten it up, because essentially you got two parts, possibly with a spring in the middle on this shaft here going to the other side. However, I've found that if I tighten this up, I can still turn it and it won't go back the other way at the moment. Things could change when the spring tension starts to build up, but I'll attempt to record it. Okay, it started to rain, so that's what the noise is all about. But here you can see the bracket. And what happened was, when I loosened that off and unwound, and I lost the spring tension. So that's fairly tight at the moment, but I am able to grip onto here and turn this around, but it won't spring back yet. So I am starting to get spring tension. So the moral of the story is, don't undo the bracket on the opposite side of the motor. Demonstrate that I can't lift the garage door. As I said, I have got some spring tension, so I was able to move it. So for this, I am wearing gloves and some form of eye protection. Okay, so that's the limit. As you can see, that's now coming back. So I'm going to have to tighten tighten it a little bit more. I think it's this one here. Okay, I'll go ahead and tighten that a bit more. Okay, now that is fully tightened. It's on the full spring tension. I'm going to bring the roller door up, but I can't lift it up. I have to roll it down. I'll show that now. Okay, now that the roller door's up, I've loosened the clamp off, but there's no tension on it anymore because the roller door's up. So what I'll do is now retension it. Okay, I'll just tighten that up a bit more. So I think what happens here is these electric motors wear out. I think this clamp on the opposite side becomes loose and it loses its spring tension. The motor has to work too hard and it breaks down. So, okay, well, I just need a little bit more tension on that roller door. Okay, success. Now, we just have to put the new motor in. Yeah, so how it works is the opposite side to the motor is the one that's under tension. So never undo the opposite side. Okay, otherwise you'll have to do the work that I've just shown to get the spring tension. Now, what we're going to do next is we're going to support the roller door. We're going to put a rope over to hold it on the ladder. And we're going to remove the bracket and take the old motor off, put the new motor on. Now, one thing I have noticed is this didn't come with the metal rods, so there's supposed to be two metal rods here, but it's not anywhere in the box. So, yeah, didn't come with that. It's a good idea to have the metal bits in there. This is what we're using. Okay. I got that from Bunnings. That's now double the price of these 12, 13-year-old model motors. That's the motor that was before those ones. Okay, so we've got the roller door supported. This ratchet strap goes right over the top, back around, hooks in here, and it's tightened up. The roller door weight is supported. You can see in there. So now we just take off the bracket, and that'll be free floating, and we'll swap over the motors and take it from there. Okay, so we can see that there's not much room there, and the metal rods only just fit into to place. So you may have to spread them apart a bit, but I think these could possibly be from the 1970s, this roller door. But that's what we're looking at there. Okay. So what I did was I just pulled this cord, and that comes out from the inside. So we'll get that situated. I think it should be free, should be some space between the drum. So we've got about 40 millimeters on that side, so I'd say possibly push it in bottomed out on something. So I'll get that sorted out now, but that's the most of the work done. Okay, so we've run into a little bit of a problem. We can see here the margin is different between the bottom of the door and the top of the door. And so what this means is on this side, it's jamming. Okay, it's too close this way. It's worked its way over this way a bit. So as we go down, let's see here, it's out a bit. So the entire top has come this way. Okay, it's the 19th of the 5th, 2023. So it's like Friday and I've got a roster day off. I'm working tomorrow, Saturday. However, what's happened here is the door's not level. It needs to come down, say, 15 millimetres on the right-hand side. So I'll get a level and show that now. So with the level on the drum, we can see that it's not completely level. It needs to come down, say, that much. It seems to be approximately 5 millimeters, 7 millimeters on that side. Okay, so you know it's completely out of whack. So the bracket needs to come down and it needs to come this way a bit. It needs to come this way, I'd say 20 millimeters. Okay. Unfortunately, I may have put the bracket on and I didn't want it to move, so this coach bolt is probably at the very top holding it up. This one's adjustable. So what also has to happen is this panel here has to be removed so I can do all these adjustments. Okay, there's no longer power in the shed, but it is what it is. So there's a number of things that have become apparent now. We do have movement in the wall. So you can hear that. I'm just pushing that backwards and forwards. Okay. Might be able to see, I don't know. Okay. And what the structure is, we've got uprights here of pine. Then it comes to this. So we've got this piece of framework here, and we've got a bit of a bulkhead there, and then we've got the top running off probably what is the frame, maybe running along there. I'll have a look. Okay, so looking on top of the roller door, we've got this beam that's unfortunately joined here and runs to the other side. That's resting on what seems to be some pine. Okay. I might use the fisheye lens. So yeah, this gives us a better view. Okay. So really, essentially, we've got two frames, the top, the roof and everything resting on this piece of pine here. Now that rests on either side and it rests here on this frame, but this, if you move this, all this shakes and we've got a join here. This is the door that's failed. Okay, so that has to be fixed as well. So when the covers on this area here, I'll have to run at least one piece of pine from the bottom right up to the top with a packer to stop the movement. So that means getting the switch relocated probably to above this here So that's a power point. This is the lights. There's no longer power to this. So this will have to be shifted here above the switch. So this is going to be another drawn out video because I'll want to show that finished. Okay, so for today we'll be shifting the roller door over and dropping the bracket down. Is this the original bracket? Yes, I'd say it is. Could even be in the same position. I don't know whether it's the movement or what it is, but the roller door is not level. So, well, let's get to, you know, what's got to be done. I suppose my videos are pretty long and lengthy. As I've always said, the only way that they'll ever be presented properly, because this is real-time work and very varied work and many different subjects, and I can't be perfect at everything. I've always said that the only way that my videos can be presented is with a new technology. Well, the way things are going, that new technology could be, that could be AI technology, artificial intelligence. Okay, so the next part of the work is to just get the measurement for how far it's got to be dropped down and how far it's got to be moved over and start working on that. Okay, so the roller door has to come over 20 mil and it's got to be dropped down 20 mil. So I'll start that now, and it's very heavy. Wouldn't be surprised if they didn't make them as heavy anymore, but well, let's see how I go about doing that. We're on the outside of the roller door now, and we can see how far out it is. So it needs to, for it to be level, it needs to come down a fair way. That's actually level there. So this is half the width of the drum. So, you know, that's about 20 mil. The right hand side is a little bit out. Okay, so that's about level there. We're looking about 3 mil. So it's not too bad. And here on the other side, pretty good. It's within, just within tolerance. Okay, so we've got the roller door wound up. It's secured here with a ratchet strap, and so either end with a ratchet strap. In the middle we've got a little bit of support, right? It's going up over the beam, back down, and that's tightened up, so that'll get some weight off the roller door. The next job will be to remove the tension, so I'll undo the U-bolt with the clamp, just relieve some tension, do it up, and then reposition the plumber's clamps, and just keep going until there's no tension. I think it's on the full tension. Then the next job will be to lower this bracket down 20 millimeters to level out the roller door. Once that's done, push it back. We can see here where it was. So that's the point there where it was. So it's got to be, I'll use a crowbar or something and push it over this way, and we'll take it from there. Okay, I've got the spring tension off, and how I did that was to, you have to loosen, like it seems like the opposite side, so facing the roller door like this, I loosened off the right hand side. And then I got my plumber's wrench on this side facing it like that to keep it there, and where is it now? I've got my socket and wrench, and I backed off the nuts. I made sure it was under control. I let off some tension, and then I would do it up again, and then I would reposition the wrench, loosen it off, back it off. It didn't take much, so only about 1-2, and that was the most of the tension. Okay, so that's now not under tension. It's a bit supported here, it's supported by the ladder. So now the next thing is, I think, to maybe drop the bracket and then try and push it over. See how we go. Okay, here's some notes. They're fairly accurate. These notes are for putting tension on the roller door, not backing it off, but tightening up the tension on the roller door. Okay, so that's fairly accurate. Okay, there's the bracket there. Now, that's the original hole, and there, we're going to have them there and there. So I'll drill those out now and put the bracket back. It's designed so that it can be adjustable, just as the original builders here. They've got one coach bolt in the middle. This one, there is a gap on top here. But they do have a nail at the bottom of the bracket so that it can, so it won't fall down. So that's it. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Okay, at this stage, let's see how we go moving it across. This is a different situation because the bracket's not even on this side. Okay, this is the main, safety feature, or to make it happen. So we're just going to shift it across. It doesn't have to come across all that much, about 20 mil. So I'll try shifting it across now. Okay, so I can obviously do that by hand, so okay, I'm just going to use this block here. I've got a few holes drilled in it, and I'll put that for my thickness for the roller door back. Okay, so what I'll do is tighten this side, and we'll start tensioning up that side. Okay, I'm going to try and record the tightening up process. So it's just undoing the bolts, tightening and then doing up the bolts again and bringing the wrench up to bring it down and tighten again. That's not good, it just went back. It moved. Okay, it did move back. But I think what it's saying is, we can see that the right-hand roller door and the left-hand roller door are out, so I might just push this back. It may be too far out. Okay, at this stage, I have shifted it over. I've done the bolts up tight again. And so let's have another go at putting the tension back on the door. Okay, at this point, I've made sure all the bracket bolts are done up. Also, the brackets for the rod either end going through the roller door, so it's all secure. So I now just start removing all the supports. Okay, well, I just had to get the left-hand side back in the track, and now the job's going again.
Okay, I'll just move the track in. Probably see a bit of a gap on top, so I'll just adjust the tracks either side and I'll see what we've got. Okay, well, surprise, surprise, there's actually too much tension on the roller door. Okay, I'll back some tension off now. Well, it's amazing. I've undone the connector there, the U-bolt, and I can't get it to loosen off. It's the most amazing thing. So I'll back off these nuts. So that this is completely loose. Oh, okay, it's just okay, it's turning now. Okay, isn't it just amazing what happens when there's more than one set of eyes on something? I hope that was caught. It was a little bit down, but when I turned the camera on and backed off the bolts, then it did actually unwind a bit. So, okay, well, let's see how much tension is on the door. Okay, there's still a bit too much, so that's it. I think we've got it. Okay, well, I have had a look around. It could drop on this side just a tiny bit. I was being conservative and I didn't bring it down to this line here. I sort of thought I'd go halfway, but then I came down a bit more. But as we can see, sorry, here, it probably could go down there. That's about 5 millimeters. So anyway, that's enough for today. Still got to pack up and get all my working tools back in the box. But that's it for today. So I'm working tomorrow, Saturday. So Sunday will be just tweaking that down a bit, getting the side tracks adjusted, but I think it'll be a success. I should have put grease on the rotating surface just there. So that bit there that spins around, that metal, and that should have been greased or had some sort of lubrication. I can't get in there. I can't spray around this join here, so that's a missed opportunity. But again, let my mistakes be your
your successes. Okay, so that's it until Sunday. Just one last thing, this gap here, because this rod was shifted over, I don't think I'll be able to get the motor off anymore. Maybe the different versions or the more expensive ones will be easier to be removed. I don't know. This one cost about $250. The next ones up are about $370. The blue ones, you get these from Bunnings. It's a home entry. The model number is on the start of the video. So maybe that'll show up a little bit. Yeah, but my point was, of course, this can be cut, okay, with a diamond tip grinder or some sort of a grinder, and then you'll be able to remove it. I would go in 10 millimeter increments and just cut off the less amount possible. Okay, well, it's the 10th now, the 10th of the 6th, 2023, so... Monday, it's Saturday now. Monday is the last Queen's birthday long weekend. Okay, so a couple of weeks ago, we decided that this would have to be dropped down to the bottom mark there. So I'll go ahead and do that now. I think from memory, once that's done, I have to adjust the side tracks as best as possible. I might have to change the spring tension, and then the roller door is done and I can start to fit the panel. I think I mentioned this before, but if you have a look at the track, it runs out. You see it runs out as it drops down. And we see it's reasonably level. That's within tolerance, but of course, as you'd expect with the side here, when we put the level on the side, we can see that it does, might try and focus that. Anyway, it, hang on, that's, oh God. Okay, might be better. We can see that, you know, it does need to come out a little bit. And so, as expected, the bottom should go in. But on the other hand, and with this house, there is always another hand. If we put it on the frame, we see that that's pretty good as well. So this situation, I'd say it's a really, really good idea to not to change anything at this point and just accept that the frame's good, the drum is good, but there's something going on with the roller door metal itself. And I'm just going to leave that at that. I'm very happy. It all slides very well. It's a little bit lighter on the up, going up, than going down. When I go down with the roller door, there is a little more tension than going up. But I'm just going to, you know, I'm going to leave fate alone. And that's working. It could work for another 10 years, so we'll just leave it at that. So that's good. That part of it's done. Now, I do have a post. I have to get the electrician in to move the switch and the electrical outlet over. so I can get my post in. I do have to cut a little bit off the rod here so that the post will go in. I think I've mentioned that, and I've got my tie-off points, 1, 2, 3. And at the top there, we'll need some packing to tie off to the top there. This side will be stabilized. If I can just light that up a bit. This side will be stabilized because it'll be connecting there, but this looks fairly good, and so the other side will be good as well. Now my post is under the house, so okay, the next thing is to have the electrical moved over and cut the cover. I don't know if I've mentioned this, but the wood panel was very, very expensive, about $45. But the upright was quite cheap, the post. So anyway, let's get on to that now. Okay, well, the electrician's been in, and now I've got my tie-in post. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 fixing points. I've packed this out with a bit of, I think it's 45 mil garden sleeper, and we can see that the wall does bend out because it's packed out here with the same lining board, and it touches here and at the top, but the gaps here. So that's a fair way between there and there, and we can see it here how the wall clearly comes out at that point. So that needs to go in, and I've got the two coach bolts there. So we'll see how it goes. This lining board will push back. Okay, so this might be a bit bowed out here, but it could be riding on the coach bolts behind the lining board. But anyway, it'll be what it'll be, and we'll see how it goes. Again, just to demonstrate what's going on here, we've got two very heavy roller doors, especially when they're both wound up. And we've got this movement here. Might be a bit hard to show, but this will flex. Okay, I'm very happy. That is definitely the way to go about securing the front if there's an issue with movement. So when I shake the wall now, there's only very minimal movement, and that's far more pressure than I put on compared to how much movement I put into moving the wall before. So now your fixing points are where your fixing points are. If you do put a lining board on, don't forget to mark the framework behind it. Okay, one on the bottom there. Very happy, and as I say, I use the sleeper behind here to fix to this framework, and the framework above making the same thickness. Okay, so now I have to put the original piece of wood here. I have to put that back. That's got a coach bolt there. Okay, that goes there and carries through to here. I'll get a fixing point off there somehow. I'll just use my imagination and there you go. There's an interesting tool, and that's how I got the coach bolt drilled out in the frame there. So as you know, with coach bolts, you have to experiment. Where's my experiment wood? Here it is. So you experiment, you make a hole that the that'll pass through. So there, that's the same measurement there. Okay, so that hole, it'll pass through under pressure. And then I think that's a 13, and I think that's an 8 millimeter. The 8 millimeter is what the thread grabs into, okay? But it has to pass through the upright, but then it has to grab inside the wood. Okay. So you just get a piece of wood, drills, and experiment with what it all seems right. So this is a 90 by 90 post. I think it's actually, you know, I think 88 or something by 88. I wound it in just with this socket and mechanics wrench. That is a little bit, that's the old one. Just wound it in. I'm glad I had the two coach bolts here. One probably wouldn't have been enough. I had to tighten them, you know, in sequence, going from one to the other to bring it in. There is, say, a 10 mil gap there. Okay, but it's the main thing is that it's completely solid. I do have a cross brace to fit from the post. I'll go probably from the side of the post to here. You can see where it was there. That's it there. It's got a coach bolt there. That'll go there and carry on through. Okay, so that'll give it even more stability. Just so that everybody knows, there is a gap between this piece of packing and the lining board. So I'll just demonstrate that this will fit right through there. Okay, so there is a gap for this lining board to move under there if necessary. It's very close to the framework there. So, well, that's just about a wrap for this one. Okay, at this stage, the roller door has been programmed. I will show the manual and the most important parts and how to go about it, but at the moment we're going to test the roller door with a piece of wood there, and it should stop and recoil. So we'll press the down button. Okay, that's a success, so we can wrap this video up now.